let's see how to activate and deactivate specific components from a game object in Unity. I'm reusing the system I built in the previous video to activate and deactivate game objects. Here in the corner, I leave the video in case you're interested in seeing how the script works. Its function is to activate and deactivate a game object when the D and A keys are pressed respectively. In the previous video, what we basically did was to check and uncheck this box through a script that activated and deactivated the entire game object. Now, what we wanna do is activate and deactivate specific components. Here's an example. I have an audio source component, a light component, a collider, a rigid body, and a script that I myself have created, which I called my awesome script. The components that we will be able to activate and deactivate, at least using this method, are those who have the checkbox. Here, if the box is unchecked, that component is inactive and it will not perform its function. Here I have the script I created in the previous video. We will do the following. If we want to disable an audio source component, we will need to define here a reference for that audio source component. We can do this with public audio source and give it the name you want. Then save the script, and now when we go to the object that has the script assigned, we see that audio source component appears in inspector with the name we gave it. Then we can assign there a game object that has an audio source component, in our case this object. So we can take this object and place it here in my audio source field. The same if we want to activate or deactivate a light component. For that, we need to define a reference for this type of a light type component, public light, and give it a name. In this case, my light. Save the script. Here in the game object that has the script, we see that reference. Take the object that has the light component and assign it to the new field. And now for the other components, it's the same process. I'm gonna do it faster. Save the script, go to the inspector and drag the game object that has the components. Notice that here we have the reference of each of the components. Now to activate and deactivate these components, simply do the following. Use the name, for example here, my audio source, dot enable equals to false. And if you want to activate this, my audio source, dot enable equals true. Notice the difference. This here is the execution of a function, and between parentheses are the parameters required by that function. Here, in this other case, we are assigning a value. In this case, a Boolean value to the enabled variable of my audio source component. I will do the same for the other components. Finished. Notice that in all cases, it is practically the same instruction. The only thing we change is the object we are using and the value we assigned. I enter in the play mode, I press the A key, and here we see that all the components are deactivated. I press D and all the components are activated. This rigid body, on the other hand, as you can see, doesn't have the checkbox to activate and deactivate, so this method could not be applied. That's all I wanted to show you, hope you find it useful, and see you next time.